the two top companies when it comes to authoring tools for online courses and e-learning. We're gonna go through the three categories that make each of these very different software solutions. Let's get at it. Welcome to eLearning Partners. We have a free masterclass for you. It is our gift to you for being here, because we want to help you guarantee the success of your e-learning program or online course. We're going to go through how to build, launch, and distribute it. Now, you could be anywhere in the e-learning process, and this is a valuable masterclass for you, because it is all about the most important part of your process, your learners. We're going to help you guarantee the success of your online course. Now, we have various masterclass testimonials that you're going to see when you click on that link. So sign up and you'll get immediate access. Thanks for being a subscriber and thanks for the likes. Let's break it down. So we're going to compare these based on pricing, based on UX, and based on number of applications, apps. So Articulate 360. Articulate 360 is the bigger of the two for a few reasons. Well, first of all, it is gonna be priced higher. It's about $1,300 plus per user per year. Now, if you're an education professional, you're gonna get a discount. If you're a student, I think you get a discount as well. So there is that. But that is the pricing for Articulate 360. Now, for Adobe Captivate, you're at about $400 plus per user per year. Now, they used to do this thing, and you might still be able to find it in different places, where you can buy just a membership forever and it's one cost, but they've changed that a bit. So $400 a user per year. So it's about three times cheaper than Articulate. Let's go into the UX. Now, Captivate also does have monthly plans. So monthly, you're gonna pay whatever 400 divided by 12 is. Articulate only has yearly. And when we're looking at UX, we're looking at Adobe Captivate being basically a way to be PowerPointy. So it's kind of a PowerPoint user experience for you as the creator meets course authoring. That's really what it is. So if you're really good at PowerPoint, you're gonna get really good at Captivate real quickly. Now, that is the positive of having a PowerPoint type user experience. Now, when you look at Articulate though, Articulate, you have various UXs depending on the different applications. And the cool thing about Articulate is you can do a bunch of custom e-learning and online course design. Pretty cool. And that really brings us to the last category here. Articulate 360 is 8 plus applications. So the main ones here are gonna be Storyline, Rise, you have Review 360, and then we just have a bunch more. For Adobe Captivate, you have one application. It's just one application. That's it. And what is it called? It's called Captivate. And that's it. So if you're talking about how much you're paying per app, you're paying $400 for one app here. You're paying $1,300 for 8 or more apps here, because they always add more apps and they make changes and all this cool stuff. So which one is better? Well, it really depends on what your needs are. Now, if you have a bunch of PowerPoints and you want to create them into e-learning, go with Captivate. If you don't have a bunch of PowerPoints, but you want to spend money on a high dollar authoring tool and have all these different customizations, and Rise is actually really easy UX, easy UX. Storyline is very hard UX, but very customizable. Then you can go with Articulate 360. Which one do I like better? I definitely like using Rise, specifically the app Rise, the best out of anything on the board, but I don't like paying $1,300 a year per user for it. So that's why I also like Captivate. Thanks again for the likes and the subscribes. We have another video for you to go check out right now, all about an LMS versus an authoring tool. We talked about authoring tools today, but what is the difference between an authoring tool and an LMS, and how can you use them together? We'll see you there.